The village of Athienou is located in the plain of Mesauria between the urban centers of Nicosia and Larnaca. Athienou is very famous for its traditional professions related to bakery and cheese making. In Athienou, there are various dairy factories who are specialized in the production of traditional Cyprus halloumi cheese. Halloumi cheese has been around for many centuries and is automatically associated with Cyprus. Halloumi cheese is also popular in Greece, the Middle East, and is now available in supermarkets around the world. Halloumi may have its origins in the Bedouin tribes of the Middle East, who probably found its long-keeping attributes ideal for their particular way of life. Its presence in Cyprus is lost in time, but it was definitely produced on the island before the Turkish invasion of 1571. In older times, halloumi in brine was an essential part of the people's diet, especially so in the absence of any refrigeration facilities. What is halloumi? Halloumi is a trademark of Cyprus and is characterized as a semi-hard, unripened, and brine cheese made traditionally from mostly sheep's milk with the addition of a smaller amount of goat's milk. Modern halloumi is made from a mix of goat's and sheep's milk, and sometimes cow's milk is added. The cheese is set with rennet and is very unusual in that no acid or acid-producing bacteria are used in its preparation. Some recipes, though, do call for the addition of starter culture, but this is traditionally not done. When made with raw milk, certain bacteria naturally present in the milk and environment will influence the flavor during aging. These bacteria will leave behind enzymes that will assist flavor during aging. Halloumi is also unique in having a high melting point and so can easily be fried or grilled. It is the high pH of the cheese that causes this non-melting characteristic. Although the cheese keeps its shape, its outward appearance turns into a crispy golden brown color when fried or browned, and with grill marks when grilled, it softens significantly but it does not melt. The other factor contributing to the non-melting character and texture of this cheese is that the whey used for skelting must first be heated to about 91 degrees to bring out the whey proteins from the liquid. This whey curd is then skimmed off and drained in baskets. In Cyprus, this whey cheese is called anari and it looks just like ricotta. The halloumi is then boiled in this clarified hot whey until it floats. Halloumi is often garnished with mint to add to the taste. Traditionally, the mint leaves were used as a preservative. This practice came about when it was considered that halloumi kept better and was fresher and more flavorful when wrapped with mint leaves. Many people prefer halloumi when it has been kept in its own brine. It is much drier, much stronger and much saltier. This cheese is very different from the milder halloumi the Western chefs use as an ingredient. Thanks to the Groovy project, we had the chance to visit the beautiful village of Athienou and to meet the people who make the famous Cyprus traditional halloumi cheese. We learned how the people of Athienou make Cyprus traditional halloumi cheese by following the traditional procedure the people of Cyprus have been using for hundreds of years.